Welcome to Scott County Hangar in Tennessee. Here we are with a picture of Stan in the morning of the 430th RAM mission to date. And we were greeted by a beautiful sunrise and clear skies, a perfect day to do a jump. Now, before we did the jump, we had to load up two of the DC-3s with our cargo. And the first one here is of Ron Talent's DC-3, where we had, I forget how many cargo bales, but quite a few, as you can tell. And then in the other DC-3, or the RAM DC-3, we had all the skydivers. And in the doorway, you can see Don Scanlon and his tandem master. We are greeting with happy smiles in the doorway. And last shot of John is he's practicing his exit. He's 78 years old, I believe, and a trooper nonetheless, a rock star if you ask me, and this was his very first skydive. Now inside the plane, we have a nice group shot of everybody as we're getting ready to either take off or we're in flight and getting ready to exit, and Waldo was the first one to go out the door. And the entire jump was videotaped, which there are videotapes of available, and you can see Jerry in the doorway. Now, this is the view of the doorway as you look out over the treetops at the border of Tennessee and I believe it's West Virginia or Virginia, or Western Virginia, thereabouts. And in the next shot, we've got Larry Richardson as he pushes out two of the test cargo bales. And we did only two on the RAM DC-3, and then the rest were skydivers that jumped out. And then Ron Talon's DC-3 jumped out the rest of our cargo. And the next few shots shows a few of us picking up the cargo bales after they landed on the ground. And you can see in our shot here with Renee and Judy Stoops, we're retrieving a cargo bale that fell off to the right side of the picture. And you can see the cargo chute itself as it draped itself over the tent that's parked next to this car. Nothing was damaged, and everything turned out all right. And another shot here of one of the cargo bales as it lays there ready for us to unbundle what's bundled in it. Now, once everyone was on the ground, we did a group shot, and this is most everybody, although not everybody that did do the jump that day. But once we got everything offloaded from our cargo chutes, we had the Tennessee National Guard show up, and they helped assemble four large military tents. So we put together the structure, and then we strapped on all the tent coverings, and we hoisted it up. And finally, once we got it hoisted up on one side, we hoisted it on the other side. And everything was in place. And slowly but surely, we got all the other pieces together and pounded in a few of the stakes with what I call the Popeye hammer from the military. And before all was done, once all the tents were assembled, we had a little bit of a rain shower and we had to batten down the hatches. But everything went well that night and it cleared up once more. And here I am taking John Scanlon's blood pressure. Now, the next morning, we got up early, and we were greeted by a long line of patients waiting for the volunteers to kick off the dentist and vision clinics. And here we have a shot of the dental clinic and also the vision clinic. And here's a shot of Mark and Sean Stannard doing their dental work. And Mark and Sean were a team that whole entire day, nonstop, and they pulled a lot of teeth. And the next shot here is of Renee and Brian Burke as they work out logistics. And here's another shot inside the vision tent with Larry Harris and Angie Berkshire, I believe. And then we have a shot here with we've got Dr. Dave Burt and John Monshine. John Monshine is actually a friend of Dave Burt, and John is a veterinarian, and hopefully on future clinics we'll have the veterinarian part of it kicked off. After our first successful day of the clinic, we headed up in one of the vans and we drove off down the road to get to the Rooster Scratch. And at the Rooster Scratch, we bought some moonshine, did some dancing and singing, and John is standing here singing. Actually, he's not standing, he's dancing. And the woman in the picture, she's singing loud and clear the song to I'm a Redneck Woman. Now, the next shot here is of Mark and a gentleman at the bar who later on sells his t-shirt. So we got Renee, and we got Doctors Dave Burt and John Monshine, then Dick and Judy Stoops, and we've got Dave Burt and John Scanlon, and we've got Scott and Angie, then Mark and Waldo. And outside, last but not least, we've got Dr. Leroy Gallenstein, and we've also got Dan Wrinkle with his coon hat, And here we are with Judy Stoops and her newly purchased t-shirt. And the next day, this guy came up for the clinic and got some vision care and dental care. And before we left, we met a man who has this dog in his arms. And he was cooking at the barbecue for the evening, and he told us that this dog has never set its foot on the ground. He has been carried around his entire life, and I think the dog's 5 or 7 years old. But before we left, Waldo scored a crossover on a card game, borrowed a couple bucks from me, and came out a winner, actually. So you can see the smile on his face because he's winning. And now the next morning, we started off early again, and people were lined up for us as early as dawn could break. And the first picture here is of the woman who operated or owned the Rooster Scratch, and she had a bunch of baseball caps for sale. And here's Dr. Scanlon one more time. And in the background is Brenton Sanders. He was the other tandem passenger during our skydive. And then here's a registration shot. We've got Sherry Massengill, Dave Burt, and Judy Stoops. And in the background, you can also make out Dr. Gallenstein. And last but not least is a shot of the teeth, which we won't dwell on, but we pulled a lot. Now, after the clinic, we packed up all of the trucks, and as soon as we got in the van ready to head down the mountain, the rain started. So the weekend was absolutely beautiful. We had cool days, clear weather, until we left. And then once we got back to the hangar, everyone drove in, and the rest of us flew out and got on back home. And here we have the last shot of the DC-3 at the REM, Remoria Medical, I guess it's a home hangar. And that was the end of the 430th RAM mission.